Welcome to my very first plan with me video. I'm a bit nervous about this one. I have no idea what I'm doing. I usually just throw things together on a bit of a whim, but I thought I would plan this one out a little bit. It was going to be a really simple washi and stickers set up today for this week, and then I watched Plum Mashable's video this morning. She did her Lawn Fawn release spread with the gorgeous little masks and bubbles and used the oxides, and so I thought I would go just a little bit further out there today and do some distressing. I get my oxides from, you can get them anywhere, but I actually am very lucky that my sister-in-law owns Crafty Divas, so I get all of my oxides from her. Alright, so what I'm planning on doing, I'm using today, I'm just going to cover the entire spread in Victorian velvet. I'm not sure whether, so I'm going to be whiting out the days of the week. I'm not sure whether I really should be doing it first. This is a terrible whiteout. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to test this first. Oh, scrap a piece of paper. Okay. So I'm going to test it over I don't even know if I'm really using this right, to be honest. Oh, yep, okay. Maybe not. But we're going to give it a go. I'm probably just going to sticker over that anyway, so. Now, my blending brush is not actually a blending brush. It's a makeup brush. Because I haven't been able to find a good blending brush, and I was only ever going to use this for my wedding planner. And I was never really going to use it again, but, okay, so, it's a bit bigger than I planned. Like I said, I really don't know what I'm doing with this stuff, so I'm just going to lay it down. However it comes out, it comes out. Now, I'm pretty much going to sticker over them anyway. Oh, okay. I'm going to white them out first because this is not working. I was only going to do a light sprinkling of this, just a bit of a dusting, but it's gone on a bit thicker than I thought. In my little notebook here, I'll just take pages out of it, which means I think I'm getting a little bit of oxide on the corners of those, on the edges of those pages, but I'm just going to have to deal with that. This is what happens when you change plan just before you start. Well, Ash from Plum Mashable must use a really good blending brush and not a, you know, cheap makeup brush. Because hers always turn out so much better than this. But you know what? That's fine. It's just for a bit of background for me anyway. Just for something a little bit different. Okay, now my original plan, I will get to you now. So I'm using washi from the Blossom washi from Planners Anonymous, because if you've seen my other planner video, my flip through, you will know just how much I am obsessed with Planners Anonymous. Now, I'm not going to be just doing this usual across the bottom and across the top. I'm going to be using these, and I didn't get out my stickers, but that's alright, we can deal with that. Oh yes, I did, right there. I like to. I like the torn look with my washi. Oh, this goes the wrong way. Oh, well, we just have to deal with that. Let's just tear that right down like that. So I'm just going to pop this up here. I do this a lot, this style, in my work inserts. And I just love how it looks. And I probably should have painted it a little bit better than this, but it's not. And plus I've got layers in the back here, so it's going over all of the bumps and not quite working the way I wanted it to. I'm going to use from the Planners Anonymous Blossom Weeks kit the days of the week. Date dots. Right, now to cover up these bits. Let's see what we can do. Shopping, which won't quite cover that up, but what I could do is I could either use a splash or one of these boxes. Tuesday, I have to drop my car in for a service So, now what? And, well, let's use some this sheet. Okay. Now what can we pop over this one? And I think what I will do with that one is use another one of these. I'm going with the florals, so I'm going to just use that one. And then that one there. Completely not turned out the way I expected it to or hoped that it would. It's just not. No, I don't want to use many of these stickers because I don't want to waste them on a spread that's not coming together the way I wanted it to. My washi cutter here that I got from Lion Mortar that I really do love, but I also really like this tool. What else we do? Let's just pop some flowers around. Yep, I think I might just put some flowers. Or I'm wondering actually. So what I'm gonna do is Sakura stamps, so that I'm not using up all these beautiful stickers. I'm going to use the Sakura stamps because I'm pretty sure they're actually the same flower. Alright, let's just start. Actually, before I do that, then it's going to need to be dried. The ink's going to be wet. So, usual my weekly stickers that I use every week. What do we think? Do we like it? I like it. I like that I've tried something different in my actual planner, my week's planner. I don't like these lines. I did them wrong. I should have practiced that a little bit before I just put it down. But anyway, I think it's come out alright. And I'm going to look forward to using this week. So let me know below what you think. Let me know in the comments. Give it a like if you like it. I'll link below to everything that I've just used. So, Planners Anonymous, Crafty Divas, Lime and Mortar. I use a lot of their stickers as well. And, I hope you've enjoyed my very first plan with me. And I'll see you next week for, hopefully, we'll see how we go. I'm not great at planning these things. You'd think with a planner I would be, but I'm not. Anyway, thank you for watching. Bye.